So my team, see me kaka in Baba. Because a tree, like they said, planted a forest. Yeah, true. I'm the initiator and the convener. But I cannot execute single-handedly. I want to say thank you to my entire team, Joe Morgan, Papa George, Chibuto, Hilary, Perry, Pandora, Eunice. So, not to mention a few. I want to also say thank you, a very big thank you to my friends who are also in the entertainment industry with me, who contributed immensely to the actualization of the Car Carnival 2016 and including 2015. Also, appreciation goes to the executive governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, who also contributed towards the success of the program. And to our honorable governor, His Excellency Senator Dr. Ifeanyi Okoh, who created a conducive and enabling environment for the carnival to happen. I want to say God bless him immensely and abundantly. So the youth of the Carland, I want to say here today that without them, no Car Carnival. I must tell you too, without them, no Car Carnival. Before now, we all keep saying there's restlessness in the land, there's insecurity in the land, there is rivalry, clashes in the land, and we keep blaming it to the youth. But today, what we are seeing, the demonstration of the youth, have simply suggested that if they are positively engaged, there will be peace in the land. That is what we experienced. I can tell you that there was no security from outside. We did not employ the services of any security agency. But because the youth saw the event as a tool to harness their God-given talent and to also help them achieve destiny in life, they decided to come together and say, no, this is a good program that will be to our own benefit. So whatever it is that we have been crying for, we have been clamoring for, we have been fighting for, this is one of the programs that will help us achieve our destiny in life. And they agreed together. They talked to themselves, not me. And they said, as for this carnival, it must be peaceful and it must be successful. And also gave their words after them that even after the carnival, we will still continue to maintain peace and show ourselves love as far and as long as the carnival has come to stay. That was just all they demanded from me. Not money, nothing. We sat down and we talked to ourselves. And I said, okay, if you people have promised this, I'm also promising that by the grace of God, the carnival will be a continuous thing. Yes, it involves so much. It is capital intensive. It is huge. It is not a child's game, I must confess. But you see, when God is in the know of anything, when God is in support of anything, I can tell you that thing will be made possible. The same God that you know created the road in the Red Sea. We might think it's just a scriptural book, but I'm telling you, this thing does exist. I don't want to begin to dwell and talk about the story, how we're able to achieve the carnival. If I start here today, we will not leave, considering the financial implication of it. But one thing I can tell you today is that that carnival, in years to come, a dime will not come out of my pocket. The carnival will sponsor and finance itself. Sir. Why I'm talking about the carnival is that when I was called, or when I was informed of my nomination as the best carman of the year, yes, it came with so much surprise, but at the same time I was happy. I was full of joy. But I decided to go further to ask the question, why was I nominated for this award? What have I done in Kalan to deserve this award? And from my investigation, we talked about another empowerment program and other activities. But above all, it was the carnival. And there, I knelt down and gave God the glory. I want to beg every one of us here. Ika is our own. It's for all of us. It's not for anybody. I listened to one of the speakers or speech from Monday, talking about the Lagos of today started from somewhere. That Anioyen. The Lagos you keep running to, or the abroad you want to run to, started from here, started from somewhere to become what they are today and where they are today. So if we keep running from the Thailand, saying we are going in search of a greener pasture in a land that are well established, then the car will never grow. The car will never be developed. But thank God, who has helped some of us to succeed out there, and we look at it, how well can we contribute to the growth and development of our various communities? And that's why we are here today. Okoh Carnival will not be sponsored by Sebastine Okoh. Our well-to-do sons and daughters will sponsor it in this world. And to every one of us who participated in one competition or the other, I want to say God bless you. Because without you, The success story of Ika Carnival would never have been completed. That is the truth. Yes, we can source for the money, source for everything, assess the competition. If you don't come to compete, what will we do with the money? What will we do with the arena? Nothing. That is why the success story of Ika Carnival is for all of us. Not for me. Not for me at all. It's for all of us. And I'm happy to say that we have agreed as people of Ika to unite together. That is a demonstration that we are one. We all agree to come together irrespective of the clan we are from. We extended love to each other. We all sat together. We wine together. We dine together. We compete together.
Save your battery.
Those are love. Then above all, the peace that Ika is enjoying today. And my prayer today is that this peace, this unity, the love and harmony we are enjoying today will never cease in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let me not bore you at all. On behalf of Team Ika Carnival, my family, who are not here presently, my friends who supported this program, we are saying thank you to all of you. We are saying thank you to the organizers of this wonderful award ceremony for peace. Would only but encourage us to do more. And we are making a solemn promise today that the carnival has come to stay. It's on this note, I want to support the organizers of this carnival with a sum of $200. And I'm also supporting, or I'm giving the youth $100,000. Finally, I'm giving my friends the physically challenged persons. They've been great, they've been wonderful, they've been very supportive. My prayer for them is that God will continue to bless them. God will give them the strength to carry on. It shall be well with you, Jesus. I'm giving them the sum of 50,000 naira.